Jonathan Paula presents Game Time. Hello and welcome to Game Time Hotshot. My name is, as you know, Jonathan Paula, and we are back again playing Earthbound on the Super Nintendo. In our last video, we mostly just explored the town of Onnit, and we discovered that almost every one of its inhabitants is a total asshole. And the head of the assholes is the gang leader of the sharks, who happens to be hanging out over at this arcade. So let's go talk to one of the guys outside and get this ball rolling, shall we?
Yeah, do you want to start a fight or what? I mean, I guess so.
You engage the skate punk! 5 HP? Oh, that's no problem. 16 to 5, I will outlast this guy. Call for help! They can do that? While I'm fighting this pogo punk guy, I thought I'd give you an update on the contest that I announced yesterday. I asked you very simply to leave a comment below and you'd be entered to win a free copy of Aroxio Game Capture Hardware. And I have already picked my winner, and once I have confirmed that he will be able to receive it and he can send me his address and we get all that stuff worked out privately, then I will go ahead and announce that winner and the winning comment as soon as I can. But for now, the contest has ended. There will be more in the future. I have a dozen copies of this hardware that we will be giving out over the coming months. So stay tuned for more opportunities to win if you didn't. I need 2 for the next level. I feel like I should probably walk around and look for a little snake or a crow to battle so I can get that 2 XP before battling more of these guys, because these guys are tricky. See, this guy, he's flying away from me. He doesn't want any part of this, because he knows I'm going to just beat him up. But I think I need some health and stuff before I do more battle with these black-suited people, whom I'm assuming are a member of the Sharks gang that we keep hearing so much about. I'm gonna go buy another hamburger. Hey, look, a trash can. Maybe I can just rummage through this instead. All right, I'm just gonna eat the hamburger I just found in the trash. Woo, maxed out HP. What are you gonna do now? Nothing. Absolutely nothing. These guys are just crawling all over the place, huh? And I got another hamburger. Awesome. Go inside this arcade here. Game station. It was you! You beat it, my buddy, didn't you? You better just beat it. I did. I took the pogo stick he was riding and bashed his face in on the curb. Nobody said anything about it, so I assumed it was alright. What's this guy? Hey, kid, you wanna become a member? Don't be such a snob. I love a good arcade. You know, I go to Fun Spot up Ware's Beach in New Hampshire a lot. I've recorded a number of Game Time videos there. Pinball machines, the classic ones, they are pretty great, in my opinion. I'm a big fan of... What is this guy's problem? Fine, everything should be equipped. Do you bother to actually equip it? Yeah, I gave you a hint. No, it's just a rocket dude. I also have to... Blah, 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 blah. So are you ready to get it on, Spanky? Call me Spanky? Oh, you better not call me Spanky! Is there anything I haven't... Oh, I was missing something. So now I'll have even more defense. Awesome. Yeah, poll question of the day. What is your favorite arcade console game? What is your favorite, like, pinball game? Or, you know, Pac-Man or Space Invaders? Even if it's a newer one. Like Fast and the Furious or I don't know what. What is your favorite one? Oh, shoot. I'm in the backyard here. What's this guy? Hey, dude, what's up? I'm Frank. You are? Come on. Can you at least say your name? My name is Suck My Dick Frank. That suit of yours is old news. Frank said something nasty. John's guts went down by 1. Smash. 35 damage to Frank. Came out swinging. 9 damage to John. John attacks. 7 to Frank. I'm not gonna use my hamburger yet. Frank said something nasty. John attacks. 10 damage. I'm gonna bash him again. Frank came out swinging. 9 damage to John. Frank came out swinging. 9 damage to John. Yes! Woohoo! I tamed Frank! I didn't know you could tame a human being, but, there you go. I just did. Fail-proof Frank can't be beaten! Puff, puff, puff. And this is Frankenstein Mark II. What are you talking about? I have to battle this? Looks like Bender from Futurama. I'm gonna start right off with a hamburger. Because I don't want to be cut with my pants down. John ate the hamburger. Threw a punch, 15 damage to John. John attacks, 9 damage to the Frankenstein. Frankenstein. Tore into you, 26 damage. That is rough. I can't afford another one of those. If he does that again, I'm gonna be dead. So let's go ahead and use life up A. HP's maxed out. Bash again. Threw a punch, 15 damage, down to 45. It's so intense. He's going for the gold. Will he do it?
Oh, come on. Tech smash! 13 damage. Yes! Just barely did it. I have 3 HP left, falling over on my butt, but I finally leveled up to level 6, and I got out of there alive. This is my first defeat. Pale-proof Frank is just now Failure Frank. I knew you've been asking around, so I'll tell you about Giant Step. It seems to be quite a powerful spot, some kind of special power stored there that allows certain people to perform wondrous feats. However, a monster sucked up all the energy at that spot. It's difficult to get the Giant Step. That's all I know. I suggest you collect more information on your own. The entrance to the path leading to the Giant Step is behind the touring entertainment shack. Perkle, the mayor of Onan, has a key to the shack. John, you've become stronger than I. Your adventure is just beginning. So, can you give me the key? How do I get the key to the shack? Huh? Hey, pal, I beat up your master. Give me all your hamburgers. Give me your hamburger, you fool. You sure are strong. You got me, at least. Yeah, I did. I did get you. That's what your boyfriend said last night. All right, where am I going now? To the mayor's office, I suppose. Ooh, a bakery. We haven't been here yet. Let's go in the bakery and see what's up. Maybe I can buy something. I'll tell you the story of the creature from the vegetable soup, but I won't because I don't want to bother you with a story that has nothing to do with your adventure. If I keep talking about unrelated stuff, you might start ignoring important messages. It's hard for you to talk to people. Also, a person might give you a different message depending on when you speak to them. Thanks, lady. That was... I wanted to talk to the guy behind the counter, actually. So if you could get out of my way, that'd be great. Hello, may I help you? What shall I get you? I can't afford anything. I would love to buy a lucky sandwich, but I don't have any money, so I'm gonna have to go to a telephone, call my father, and get some money. Or just go to the ATM directly, I suppose that works too. Police station. Can't go there just yet. Talk to this, chick with the pigtails, though. Heard a guy stops to read each bulletin before he encounters, then he says, Checkaroonie. Is that you? No, it's not me, bitch. Road to Tucson. Checkaroonie! Ha ha ha! Now I run away and hope she doesn't catch up to me and try to go out on a date with me. She seems like a Kimmy Gibbler from Full House kind of a character, doesn't she? Definitely see that. And I'm gonna use the Atom to get my money out. 254! Shit, I'm loaded! Let's call Mom. Is that you, John? You called me back sooner than I thought. Everyone here is doing just fine. Oh yes, Tracy started work part-time for Escargo Express. Here, I'll let you talk to her. Tell me when you have some time. Oh, you don't have any free time? Well, here's Tracy. Oh, this is Tracy. Escargo Express, is that you, big bro? It's me, Tracy. Working part-time for Escargo Express, we're gonna get you. Delivery. We don't have any of your items in storage right now. Come again, bye. Oh! I see what they do there. Everyone, every member of my family contributes in some way to the actual game itself. My sister allows me to store items when my britches get too full. Go all the way around the front, around these bushes here. I don't know why the town hall just has grass in front of it. You'd think they'd have a walkway, but... Mayor Brickle, he has a lot to worry about these days, am I right? Let's go upstairs and talk to the mayor. I should have an appointment now after beating up Frank. Since you beat up the sharks, you're the talk of the town. Mayor Brickle's waiting for you. See? I knew it. I'm kind of a big shot. Kind of a big deal. Move aside, lady. Hey, what's up, Mayor Brickle? Hey. I'm Mayor B.H. Brickle. So nice to meet you. Beat up the town bullies, punched them out big time, kicked their butts, bit their heads off, spit in their eyes, and made them wet their pants. And you forced them to not to make any more trouble. What? You want a key to the touring entertainer shack? For someone as great as you, giving the key could help keep the town peaceful. However, you encounter a dangerous situation. Please don't ask me to take any responsibility. Be able to avoid any responsibility, right? No. I'm a very important man in these parts. Do you think I'm important? No. Look, I'm the big cheese around here, and a brat like you should realize when someone's trying to be nice. Hey. Oh, I gotta go through the whole thing again. Sometimes it's fun to reply in the negatory in these games because they will give you, like, a sassy, sarcastic response that eventually just works its way back around to the yes, because in order to advance the game, I need to say yes here. So, you can never say no and end the game, which is why I like to say no periodically, just to see what happens, because it's usually a lot funnier than the yes answer. It is time to venture up to the entertainer shack that we saw earlier, and start making our way towards Giant Step, which is the first big goal of this game. Wow, you won! I didn't even have to fight him and I got 4 XP. Can I do that with the crow? Excellent! It's free experience. That's what I like about this game, is it doesn't even waste your time. Once they know you're, like, super strong, and you're going to automatically defeat everybody, They just give you the experience and don't waste your time with the battle, because like at this point in the game, he's so strong, he doesn't need to fight any of the snakes, crows, or doggies. So I just got, not a lot of experience with those four battles, but, it's better than nothing, I would say. Alright, so now we're up here. I have the key to the door. The door is locked. I will use the key. Good. Key. Key to the shack. Use. Trying to use the key to the shack. The door opened. Woohoo! It should have just, you know, been used automatically, but, you know, I'll take it. This is where you guys live? It's disgusting. There's a hole in the back of your house. Bunch of heathens. Vagrants. No wonder your makeup sucks. You have to do it in the trash every day. All right, we are now inside the cave. Let's do battle! Look out, you tiny rodent. Your ass is mine, pal. Bash to the tiny rodent. Whoa, watch it, pal. What is that all about? It's a good thing I got him in one attack, because he was, All right, sweet. Leveled up here. Because he was really doing some damage to me there, and that's not cool at all. You ever have to dispose of a mouse or a mice in your home? What the heck was that, a little bug? I have to fight bugs in this game? The Black Antoid. Called for help, but no one came. 14 of the Black Antoid. Is attacking 15 damage, shoot! Just missed. 14 damage, and he's dead. Thank you. I took a chance. I didn't know if I'd be able to make it out alive, but I took a chance. John, with a present, there's a skip sandwich. I think everyone has one or two good rodent stories, and I have a few whoppers. So I'm going to go ahead and share them now, because we really have nothing else to talk about while I'm battling these four separate antoids right now. Attack slugs, whatever they're called. There are four of them. Let's start with A on the left. And I already became tame. All right, good. So, I have a few good rodent-related stories. This is when I was still living at home with my parents. I was probably in high school, probably like 16 or 17 years old. I come home from school, and, you know, I go to the bathroom, and then I head back out into the living room. And when I'm in the living room, I sit down to watch TV. But as I'm approaching the couch to sit down, I notice there's something on the windowsill behind the couch, across the room. And it is a squirrel. It is a big, fat squirrel. Oh, John fell asleep. John woke up. Uh-oh. And the thing was, it wasn't outside the windowsill. This squirrel was inside my house. And that freaked me the fuck out. Because I go to sit down, and that's like the creepiest, most unnerving thing possible. I was freaked out. I opened all the doors and windows. I just kept yelling at it. I was like, you need to leave. Eventually, I just kind of like stood off to the side of the room because I didn't want him to like lunge at me or bite my face with rabies. I wasn't necessarily scared of it, but it was just like, it was so freaky. I didn't know what it was going to do because I knew that it was cornered. So I wanted to make sure I didn't piss it off because squirrels can be bad news. Eventually, he ran outside, and I was able to close the doors, and that was the end of that. But the other rodent story I have takes place in my parents' lake house here in New Hampshire, up by Winnipesaukee. And this has actually happened, I want to say, on two or three separate occasions, which is that we have had a bat fly into our home. And it makes a little bit of sense in New Hampshire because of where the house is on the lake. We have a lot of tall pine trees. There's a lot of bats' nests up there. And honestly, I prefer that because they get rid of all the mosquitoes. But every now and then, they'll find their way into the house. And most of the time, we just leave the door open or there's like a screen door. So them getting in doesn't seem that implausible, honestly. Sometimes we have the windows just wide open. So we pull in late at night and we get into the house and we're about to sit down and watch TV and unpack our bags. And then we just kind of see a shadow dart across the back corner of the room. So Becca just immediately starts freaking out. So this bat is flying back and forth from the kitchen to the living room, and he's making like these really low sweeping passes. The girls are like basically up on the couch, cowering under a blanket, and this bat is making like these dive bombs into the couch area and coming just like a foot off the ground. And we are trying to corner it and somehow just direct it outside. We had all the doors open, and we're just trying to convince this stupid flying bat just to leave us alone. And eventually, we managed to somehow just trick it into flying back outside, and then everybody calmed down, and the peasants rejoiced. But it was scary, because it's the kind of thing, even in a well-lit room, the bat is not something you can really see. It's just kind of like a fast-moving shadow. And when that fast-moving shadow is making dive bombs for you when you're hiding on the couch, that's pretty scary to most people. And Riley and I would just try to, like, avoid it, and every time it would fly through the room, we'd have to literally duck and dive out of the way while also swinging a pillow at it. It was a good time. The magic butterfly made John relax. Oh, so did the soothing sounds of Tom Brokaw. Back inside the cave, and our battle continues. I'm still in the first chunk of this game here, the first 5-10% of this game, and I'm already at, like, 100... HP points, and I already have a couple good attacks under my belt, and now to climb this rope that someone conveniently left here in the middle of the wilderness. Whoa, shit! What's this, buddy? Alright. You finally got here. This is the first your sanctuary location, but it's mine now. Take it from me, if you dare. Oh, bloody hell. Alright, so this is the first of 8 major bosses in the game, and we are about to battle this dickhead. Let's go ahead right off the bat and do PSI money! A biting attack, uh-oh. Yes! 79 damage. Oh, there was another guy behind him. 20 damage to John, 17 damage to the ant, 17 damage to me. I can only withstand about 2 of those. Another biting attack, 21 damage. Let's hope he, doesn't kill me. Oh, he tried defense instead. Good, I'm still alive then. John's defense went down by 1. I tried life up A. My HP is maxed out. The battle continues. Used a biting attack. 23 damage to John. John attacks. Shield A. Body was protected by a shield of light. 9 damage. I'm gonna attack him again with money. Even though this is my last attack I'll be able to use. Hopefully it will be enough to really hurt him. 70 damage to him. How much does this guy have? Yes! Excellent! That actually was not all that difficult, considering he was supposed to be the first major boss battle. Look at that, 759. Went up to level 10. Offense. Maximum HP went up by 3. PP by 2. John realized the power of healing A. Awesome, I have a new ability under my belt. And, congratulations, Mr. Roboto. We have made it to the first area. Awesome. John caught a glimpse of a small, cute puppy. John's soundstone recorded the melody of the giant step. Boop, 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 boop. No problem here. So, yeah, that's all you get. You just get a little melody, get a little thing. Let's see if we go to soundstone, see if it does tells us. Use. John touched the soundstone to his forehead and gathered his thoughts. Aw, sweet. So now we can see we have 1 of 8. That is pretty bitchin'. So that's kind of our progress report for the entire game. We are 12% finished. Excellent. Now we have to retreat. Luckily, on the way back, now that we've vanquished their giant ant-sized leader, they're going to fear us. They're going to run away. I'm going to make them sure that, like, hey, don't mess with John. You mess with me, you get the bash attack. It's so much more refreshing to battle your way back, because it's kind of like the victory lap. A lot of RPGs don't even make you do this. You beat the boss, and then they give you a second exit that you don't have to fight your way back. Now, this game has a tremendous story, a really great battle system, really memorable characters and plot, and everything about this game is, quite frankly, it makes it one of the best ever, especially in the RPG category, but quite frankly, just in general, one of my favorite games of all time. This is like a top 10 for me, easy. But I would say the one negative of Earthbound is the battle UI. It's just, you don't even see, you know, the Ness character on screen. You just see like a floating little box that just kind of bobs up and down, which is kind of weak. I like the setup they have in Mario RPG. That game came out a few years later, obviously, when graphics were a bit more advanced. But they actually, you know, they show the enemies attacking you, and they show, you know, your party in the lower left corner. And the same kind of goes for even Pokemon, where they have a little bit of a heads-up display where they can show you a few things. And it's too bad that this game's, like, only real fault is that the battle scenes just kind of look kind of boring. It's just a bunch of enemy sprite silhouettes on a, you know, psychedelic background, and that's pretty much the only thing you have for the battle. There's no attack timing. You can't see what the attacks look like. It's just kind of the little box bobs its head, and then the enemies fall down. So I'm just kind of going around right now and trying to grab extra experience points. I want to try to level up a couple times before I leave here. I don't see any reason why not, because at this point, these guys are giving me a lot of experience per thing, a few battles and I'll be level 12. And quite frankly, I don't really have any chance at me anymore. I'm killing them in one or two hits, and I'm getting free cookies, and it's working out for everybody, I would say. Now, as we make our way out of the first big dungeon cave area of the game, our soundstone has the first Your Sanctuary location recorded on it. We are 1/8 finished with the game Earthbound. Back outside and, hey you, the board says do not enter. Couldn't you read it? No, I'm illiterate. What a rebellious kid. Come to the Onit police station later. No problem, Jim Carrey police officer. So that is where we're headed next, but unfortunately that adventure will have to wait for the next video, where we will have to battle the Onit police force in order to get passage into the next town, which is aptly titled Tucson. But for now, that's going to have to do it for this adventure. Thank you, as always, for watching and listening. My name is John, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.